expressions of skill and whatnot.
Especially in the highest competitive form, such as VCTC, and especially such a crucial series at that. It's an elimination series once again, everybody. Fancy United Esports gonna be starting on defense. Meanwhile, Unsigned 5 on the attacking side. We'll see, map number one, here we go.
I miss seeing Viper.
Me too.
I'm glad we're seeing her a bit more now, because she's one of those agents where she's not necessarily adapted for something now. Hey, before
Oh, dashing through, and Vixie getting a double right off the bat. All they had to do, lie in wait, and Vixie might get a third. And that is huge. Again, Boxy, the only one left. They all fought over there. It's just over after that.
I'm glad I predicted Unsigned 5.
Yeah, you did.
Remember, guys, that's how the predictions went.
That's true.
I'm Raph totally
went
not
for you
to...
five. Yeah. Wait, no, you did. You did Fancy.
That was the bit. That was the bit. You know that I picked a different team. It's okay. Now I have to explain the joke too. But as of now, we really just saw aggression being punished and getting obliterated by Unsigned 5 here. So, you know, this is going to be a very easy round for them to play out.
It was such a different kind of round too. It was more like, let's hold, see if they push. Okay, they pushed. Let's kill them all.
Yep, pretty much.
Yeah.
That's my favorite call. Yep. Pick him in the head.
Vixie with an amazing start as well, building through that showstopper almost immediately. Crazy stuff.
Yeah, I was about to talk about that too. Now, Vixie, we just talked about how high his ADR is, and you know, getting a 4k on the opening round will definitely help that case. Now Fancy, they are stuck with a lot of flashes and not a lot of weapons. They could still do something cheeky here. Now we'll just count out most of them, at least one.
Flushing out towards the Yoru player, Twilight, off of that angle. It's a good stack and a good read if they If U5 just pushes through B.
We've seen the classic do a lot of crazy things.
Might not be at all. Vixie again gonna jump through. Elbow nicely done. Stun doesn't stop Vixie at all. Now things are just falling apart. It is that anti-ego. U5 in the blink of an eye just shuts down this entire round.
Man. My fancy prediction is looking real. I mean, your fancy prediction is looking
Excuse
real.
Excuse me? Okay, everybody. The prediction was... Raph went fancy. I went U5.
And Riku went fancy.
Just to set the record straight. Oh, wait, to be fair, it's just round three, Raph.
Yeah, again, just to set the record straight, guys. I predict whoever is going to win. Because my pick-ups are never wrong.
Nice save.
Nice save,
Raph. Nice try. NT. Now it's the buy round for Fancy. We have not seen the creativity. We've seen the draft creativity, but we have not seen it in action just yet. Maybe this is the time.
So here's the thing with this. It does look like U5 are just going to go right at it.
Yeah, not stopping, not waiting. Mia
planted
over here from Bats, unable to find the target. The plant has, the spike has been planted already. Doesn't rush through, doesn't check the side. And that's Doctor already finding the kill. Molly, but the teleport is gonna force Twilight really far away. And now they have to walk manually back. 6 HP. Not sure how much of a value, unless you get that very good headshot. But they're really holding U5.
So this is where you kind of have to be a bit critical of the composition, right? But again, it's only round three. You still have yet to see Fancy warm up. But going back to my point, this is a really good comp on paper. It has a lot of potential. You have, you know, even with just Astra, you can slow things down. You can combo into whatever nade you want to combo into.
What are they doing over there? When the play's not working, call an audible.
The opponent, suppress the opponent with a KO. And then you have a bunch of stuns from Foxy and Nia. Twilight obviously has the flashes too. On paper, right? That sounds amazing. But the execution is just difficult. And I feel like that's why we do get these, you know, comps that are tried and tested. You throw out the Sky Flash, you throw out the Gecko Dizzy, all is well. Fancy, you have a real chat at flashing your own teammates.
That's true. That's very true. Mercy's Gecko needs more precise coordination. Fixie, on top of the box, gets a drop on it. Ones at Bats. They need to clear that to prevent any envelopment play whatsoever. They're lost in the smoke, lost in the sauce. Now they know it's a teleport as Mia clears lamps as well. It's complete chaos over here. Fancy is winning this one out. Flaring, not gonna take the grab net, instead waits for the line above the crosshair. And that decision is really high IQ. Fixie, ready for the crosshair as well. Even with the peak, ready for a possible swing. And grenade. Even a lineup of the grenade. It's 36 one HP. Now it's on half. Left kills the diffuser. Now it's 1v1. Coily with 60 HP and a triple at that. Do they have the time? No. U5 still with a 4-0 start.
Incredible. And U5. You know, I really like how they play that. Fancy did research a little bit with those multi kills, but need plus the mosh pit into everything. Great, great stuff here by U5 recognizing the strength of this comp. Speaking of, I am surprised Fancy is not throwing out more flashes on these retakes or just reactively doing it. Because once again, if you look at this team, this has a lot of, I can make this as uninteractive as possible. But Fancy is not doing that. They're not throwing out their utility. Where are the reactive flashes? Where are the reactive presses? There's one, but...
This is the chance. Yeah, if they teleport right here, here's the slide. Nice concuss. Frieza with a trade. The doctor, though, is not stopping as well. Yes, I can. Just being this big vanguard onto paths, but flaring is right there to shut everything down. Now, all up to Twilight still has two flashes in hand. But if you're dead, you can't use that at all. Markel, this is a 5-0 start. This is a dominating start here, Raph.
Yeah, I mean, I would like to say that Yoru does get better as the round progresses. But once again, you kind of have to establish that, yes, I'm willing to teleport. Yes, I'm willing to put myself in dangerous spots. And I feel like we're not seeing that with Fancy. It feels like they're playing quite standard when they're really not running a standard comp. Now U5, they're running the basics, but they're running it very well, Riku.
I know.
We need to trade. Hey, we need to double up here. Hey, we need to nade this spot. And I like it that they're keeping it simple. Fancy, they really gotta pick it up a little bit.
Yeah, it's one of those things where I have a lot of tools, but not exactly seen utilizing them just yet. Foxy with the barrier mesh, stopping them in their tracks. At least dodges the thrash. Overdrive activated. Having to destroy that barrier can be a nuisance for sure. And here comes the teleport, actually. And now they're enveloped. Now they're surrounded. Flaring trying to find that shot, but Markel catches him with Fixie following up with another kill. Foxy the only one left. It's going to be very, very hard. Gets stopped in his tracks with the barrier. But it doesn't really matter. Four against one, and you're surrounded. There's nothing much you can do with this situation.
Stamp with a wax seal. U5 get another round on the board as Fancy continue with their struggles. Hopefully they get a little bit of breathing room here, Riku. They have a lot of utility to work with now. Ultimates, they only really did expend that overdrive to somewhat balance out the firepower. But U5, it is a completely different story. Fixie is here, 13-3, really styling on a lot of people. And I'm really excited for the fighting game that is being teased there. I'm actually curious if they're going to use those characters as a bit of a cameo, too.
That's true. I mean, who knows? Frieza. Still two?
You asked who knows.
Who knows? Nobody knows. Maybe we'll find out soon in just a few. They're already trying to go. There's a sonic sensor, so they can't really rush this long.
Foxy, don't do it.
Don't do it. Sensor trick. But not everybody is concussed. Not everybody ate the grav net. Mia, gonna reposition here, expecting a push from Hookah. But lo and behold, everybody's gonna rush from Long. And here comes the wrap around. The plant is about to go down. And here we go.
They can't sniff out their doctor, then that orbital is as good as another seal onto this round. If I practically have this in the bag, if they cannot, once again, find all the stall utility, Riku.
Okay, nicely done. Nicely done by Mia. Now they have full control over this crossfire. Fast lane. With the orbital strike now being utilized all there on Sick Garden as Mark L has an angle on Elbow. Mia, how do you deal with this? With a lineup, with a Molly, with everything. Oh now it's up to half. You push through this, you cannot. As Mark L shuts you down and you five, they're not stopping.
Not at all. This U5 train has no brakes. In fact, it's only rolling through Faxi right now. And if you're not a Twice fan, I hope you still got that reference, but I'm pretty sure you did. Anyway, going back to it. U5, I think really impressing everybody here. Once again, they're keeping it simple. They're keeping it kosher. Fancy, on the other hand, you see a lot of ideas being thrown around. But the execution, I feel like, is somewhat lacking. They do have a few tools to play around with, but ultimately, this looks like yet another round going in the way of U5.
How? Still able to spot that out. Beautifully done by Fixie again. Just wowing the crowd. As now Cruz minus one. They don't have their controller anymore for this retake. And now the Viper Spit utilized as well.
Difficult this is for Fancy, but Twilight could make it just a bit easier if you can find another.
Shut it down by Riza once more. Fixie lingering around, playing and fire with a Bucky on Mia's hands. Forced to reload, 1 HP. Might get caught out by a stray bullet. All Fixie has to do is gray shots. And just like that, U5 again and again.
Magic 8 ball. Is this where Fancy are gonna retaliate? They do have a full buy now. But
one enemy remaining.
I don't want to sound like a broken record, but I feel like the utility here is severely underutilized. They have so much.
Like, I think the dimensional drift was used earlier, as you can, like, Twilight has only 3 orbs. And it was, I think he got taken down before he's able to, before it kicked in.
Ah, man.
Yeah. Quite unlucky.
Really is. At the same time, I wonder what could be going through the head of Fancy right now. Maybe they're thinking this is going to be the slickest comeback ever. And I'm hopeful. With U5, they have yet to really show us what they can do on the defense. Their lineup, again, pretty decent at doing that. I actually quite like that they brought the Fade in, because this is not a popular choice for second mini anymore. And they are making a lot, I mean a lot of value with it. So, once again, big plus on that. Fancy. Now what?
That's indeed the question. 50 seconds on the clock, still unable to find a pick elsewhere. Maybe now! Look at that! That is such a significant 2k for Cruz.
Indeed it is. Now that's going to alleviate a lot of the pressure. But at least Fancy can breathe. We did ask, is this the round where they retaliate? Signs and forecast pointing towards yes.
Even has the crosshair at the ready.
30 seconds left.
The stars, the smokes are down. They jump right through. No flash for you. Was flaring. Finds a kill on the yes, I can. Flaring unable to dodge the stun at all. And Foxy, there we go. They break momentum. Fancy gets their first win on the board.
This could be the start of something new. This could be the comeback for Fancy, but U5, they still have a commanding lead and a commanding bank account to really roll with the punches here. Still not going for that operator. Feel like they are maybe worried that the flashes could overwhelm them and maybe the CC in general on the side of Fancy. What we were noticing too, Rico, there's not a lot of map movement. If there is a hit on a site, it's a commit.
That's true. Not a lot of rotations, not a lot of teleport plays as well. Maybe this is another commit with the Thrash now used. Fixie going alongside that. Trigger discipline onto the clone. And looks like they're unable to do much. At least they're able to take space.
Sometimes that's the most important thing. Yeah, that's the margin of error I'm talking about.
But still, the stun! Twilight takes advantage in the end. Thrash, part two. I've seen this movie before. Unfortunately, it doesn't end really well unless Flaring and Margell lands a plot twist. But look at this crew's coming from behind, and exactly like that, constricted, unable to breathe, and Fancy wins a second.
Maybe this is what they need to do, Riku, be a bit more aggressive with the utility that they have, and snatch away the avenues for E5 to set up. And look at that, they were so preoccupied that they didn't know a lot of the map was being taken away. Twilight has the operator in hand now and does have the drift back in his stead. E5, they still have that Rolling Thunder, but Dart. I'm forgetting the name now. No, don't give me no hints. I think I know this.
It's, yep, you got it.
It's Fatal. Anyway, they still have that if they really want to initiate. And it looks
face
like they can go for that.
Yep, there it is. Nightfall activated. Twilight, we're out of there, but instead, even though it's a blind, no way, yes, I can get that one kill before he falls. And Nia rushing through from Baths. And now they move, they use the teleport. Here it is, Flaring is able to spot out, has an inkling, has a feeling that the order is there. Decide to go through long instead. Now they're practically surrounded. An operator angle after they drop from above. Flaring has to be careful now. They know where the operator is. He's able to cross. Gonna challenge. They need to clear this if they want to get the spike down. And Flaring, he's gonna be surrounded. And Fancy, three in a row now.
Last round. Continuing to string along a lot of these rounds is Fancy. Maybe they've hit their stride. They do have a Cosmic Divide and an Annihilation, which we have seen very valuable in the previous series. We're waiting for Fancy to get a good pick off with that and maybe pivot off of this ult. Now U5, it's their turn to adjust. I like to say this, but you know, sometimes adjustments are just so finite. Your brain can only handle so much. And hopefully that's not the case for U5 here.
Yeah, it's definitely their turn again to adapt to cruise. These first bloods have been crucial onto short. Fixie, now in enemy territory. Gravnet's not gonna get anyone's cruise repositions. There it is. Very crucial, by the way, as he has Cosmic Divide, and now it's gone out of this retake. Nia gonna try to lurk around. The Breeze finds his head first, and the Doctor follows up.
Wow.
The Twilight, the only one left with this operator. Look at the reflex this there from the Annihilation. Something fly across the map. And here we go. Twilight, he finds a kill. Nope. Fixie finds him first. That's gonna be the first round of the half. It's gonna end in 9-3.
Switching sides.
That's right. Maybe we've set
up. Oh, not just yet. Oh yeah, there it is.
The
swap unsigned 5 in a very big lead, while Fancy has been trying to reel it back in. And here comes the swap.
Well, hopefully this is a better starting point for Fancy, as they do have a lot of things to throw out at U5, but the
Doctor is in and sending a lot of people out of there as Riza gets another follow-up kill. No plant just yet. We're in a very tight corner. Not a lot that they can do with the people just stacked up onto Bass. And that is it. The double digits for U5.
Shoot the bad guys. How's that for a plan?
I was about to say, like, yeah, the flashes are going to come into play, the stuns. Yes. Fancy just don't have the margin for error to, like, take their time to warm up. Because now it looks like on side 5, they mean a whole lot of business. Fixie again has been breaking this team down. bit by bit, brick by brick. Fancy, despite the composition that I'm quite a fan of, has not been as effective as we all thought they could be.
Yeah, we were really excited about this composition. Maybe it's more effective on attack. Us flaring with a very nice off angle, but they just get out of there.
They do. And now things are slowing down, which is going to play into the hand of this outlaw. They still have a lot of stars available, and once again, just a lot of stuff to throw out. But again, it's an eco, so maybe they're reserving that. Not find anybody. Pixie, look at that. Big two.
Fancy shots. They just wanted the cross, but the deny.
One enemy remaining.
Three just
enemy.
The one.
Spike planted.
Getting out of there. What is that shot, Pixie? Ain't no way.
Ain't no way indeed.
I'm just shocked.
I'm pretty sure that's you're pretty shocked too. Like, my.
We have died. 11-3 now. By U5, as we take a look at it again.
One enemy remaining. Three
mummy. Oh dear. And again, are we gonna have like another four? Yes, we did actually get a 4K on Pixie, and he is even closer to that orb, or rather to that ult. One more orb on both sides, and he is gonna be right as rain. Fancy. This is potentially the round that breaks the entire like map for them. Because if not, they'll have to force it out.
So we're winning bonuses, but here comes the stun. Leah is gonna dash right through the transfer. Was just stellar, as Nia is gonna continue on with the pain alongside Twilight, and they just rush through. This is exactly what we expected, especially with this composition on attack.
Yes, we need more of this if Fancy want to remain competitive, and it'd be just a shame to not see them progress in the tournament.
Time to jump.
Five though, they're making a really good case of why they belong with the big dogs, as they. I guess they don't really mind going for the exit here. At the same time, they have no real reason to keep these weapons.
Mm-hmm. Very true. Maybe Fixie wants that outlaw. It has been so effective. Might even get a second kill. First kill, rather. There it is. Maybe just... Oh my god, the judges are all going near! That ballet, it could have been disastrous, but they anticipated. Nia. Very, very big opening kill. Vandal? Nope.
Oh, man.
Keep that one.
I was about to say, if anything, they'd rather keep the outlaw than the judge. Because some of these players still have half armor, that's true specifically. They have upgraded. They have seen the threat of the two-shot machine. They will go by that. Now, Pixie, I thought he would go for the op there, but op's the rifle instead. U5 are looking for the stability. Meanwhile, Fancy. Things are on the up and up for them. Now, how are they going to flood out? I mean, if you really talk about the Execute Riku, they could suppress into like a bunch of layered stuns into the flashes. I think that's like the simplest thing.
Five, get their match point, or will Fancy continue with the streak?
Good question. Waiting for some answers here.
Ooh!
Wow.
That was very brave. Even staying over there. There is the stun. Rezo actually was able to get the clone and is punished for that. Flaring, able to get one at least now. The drop, the dodge and the stun. Oh, sorry. The dodge and the flash is going to work out, but against four looking at you, that's not going to be too advantageous. Fixie and Doctor, the only ones left once more. One with the judge. A bit awkward here from Hookah, unless this is actually the most effective position for this gun.
I was about to ask, like, you know, since the round is over and whatnot.
Mm-hmm.
I think we're ever gonna get an agent that has like a Zonia's effect.
Zonia's League of Legends, activates your golden state where you're unable to move but also unable to take damage. Yes.
I feel like that'd be cool, but also a way to grief your teammate.
Maybe it's good for orbital strikes when you're the spike planter. You just press Zonias and you're good to go.
That's the thing, right? Like, I wonder if we're ever gonna get like a Zonias theme agent.
Let her go!
And obviously, we have Zeri and Neon. That's the most obvious like parallel we have.
Uh huh. True.
Do we even have other parallels? Is the question here, or the other question? Raze has a rocket launcher, so you know. Jinx
Arcane!
It is so far, though, like,
yeah,
by design, right? But before we get distracted here, folks.
True.
U5 does have a lot of allowance to play with, but they have to make sure that Fancy don't get the confidence they need to start steamrolling these rounds. That's gonna be a big problem. We wanna end this as quickly as possible.
Yep.
All things considered, this is their map pick, so they have to defend it as well as they can.
Yeah, they don't want to get stuck with a curse of staying at 11 for so long. We've seen this in Valorant for quite some time where you get stuck at 11, they catch up, then it's overtime, then you kind of exhaust a lot of your stamina, your mental, you know, fortitude on very... It's a very stressful series, by the way. This is an elimination series, so it's a lot on the line for both of these teams, but U5, of course, they were in the lead. They had, what, a 7-0, 6-0 start? They don't want to lose it.
Yeah, I mean, like you mentioned, there is a lot of stress here. And I feel like there's a psychological factor, too. They have no idea Foxy is here.
Foxy, wait. Oh, Riza, though. Even though they know that still Foxy hits the mark. Does Foxy know that somebody's going to be coming out of tube? Yes. Instincts come into play. Very important.
30 seconds
2K.
Left.
Now it's Cruz again catching Fixy. Off guard. This is not that's not what they want. Now they get the plan on to B.
One enemy remaining.
Confusing times here, but Cruz does get one more. So the spike is planted. And U5, they're really only down to flaring here. He does have a little bro. I doubt he's able to. Yeah. Foxy versus Fixy.
True. Very real of you to say, honestly. Yeah. They both, you know, come in huge in a lot of these rounds. First half, it is a lot of, you know, Fixy highlight reels. Meanwhile, Foxy, able to get a lot done all by himself, lurking onto B. And that's the contrast between these two teams. You know, U5, a bit more straightforward. Fancy, having a lot of fancy feet across the map.
They do have a lot of legwork to cover still. They still have not punished this. Markel has done this 3 times in a row now.
Yeah!
They'll find value, that's crazy.
2 times as well. Markel still pushing long, gets punished by Foxy. Fixy over here, Annihilation activated. Where that's gonna go? Actually from behind, the Doctor is out officially. And they can't reach him at all. And again, without even the plant going down, U5 caught in a very awkward situation.
Wait, this does give... Okay, guys, very funny. Does give Fixy a potential 1v1.
Planted.
But now since they've relinked... Actually, it's still possible. If they hear the steps...
Definitely can hear. Knives out. Yes, they can. Good read. And now... 11-7. It's getting really close now. U5 still unable to find their groove back.
You don't want it to stop here, you know. Once again, once Fancy gets like 8 even, you get really worried. I mean, what happened to all that momentum? I feel like they had a good idea and what to do. I mean, just let them burn their utility and we'll fight them off on, I guess, decently even ground. But again, some of these adjustments are really obvious to us and the audience because we can see everything and how the utility is being used. So, a little bit of that. Meanwhile, U5, they've now... Actually, no, this is still the same action, but granted, the only difference is flaring. Is ready to swing out for Markel, but there's no action on that side of the map. And Fancy, they've really changed their rhythm and tempo here.
A bit of a default start for Fancy this time, not a stack onto long, but they're now moving. Nobody's taking the bait. Nobody's pushing their positions at all from the side of U5.
No, Not at all. I like the patience. Fancy, they know momentum is definitely in their side. And they do have a Cosmic Divide and the Overdrive if they choose to use it. Just with the Cosmic Divide, that's a lot of utility to worry about. Maybe some definite silence if they throw their
Flash. It's gonna work out. Flash spent too fast. Like, they have no idea that Twilight has infiltrated their territory. And Margil gets a double from far away. And they have to look back, actually. And now it's all up to Riza and Vixie again to take this
30
round
seconds left.
Back. But Nia, or sorry, Fancy, are in both land positions. Actually, they're stuck in the middle. They don't see this from Riza at all. Even having the Seize and as well as that Scout, they have a Crossfire set up. Nia with a peek as well. 1v1 situation. Bucky versus Vandal. Doesn't expect the player on top. And there we go. Fancy catching up to U5.
I think this is where U5 called for a timeout, no? Maybe reassess the situation. Because that is 5 unanswered rounds. I know they like the number 5. Can't let this continue any further. The dreams of defending this map.
One enemy remaining.
I wouldn't say dwindling, but it is getting into dangerous waters.
Yeah, it is a huge lead. What was it? It was a 10-2, right?
Yeah.
At the first half. And now look at that.
No, it was 9-3.
9-3. Oh, yeah. My memory. Lamel. Fixie. Beautiful shot. Satchel out of there. And that's value.
Go, go, go.
A lot of it, too. Mm-hmm. They do lose one of their duelists. Fixie.
Beautiful flash. They get a trade. Barrier mesh on to spawn onto CT. Riza. Let's see if they take advantage of this. Do they expect this though? Orbital strike as well. And amongst the chaos, Riza tries to take advantage. Nightfall activated. Utilize everything. Now they guess where everybody is at. Nia. Oh my. This flank. Will Mark L be there first to spot this out? Or will the damage be done? Yes, I can. With a crossfire. There it is. Mark L has eliminated the 1v2 situation. 55 health. There's just a lot, and I thought they're going to line up. And there you go. U5 breaks that 11th mark into match point.
Match point.
Ooh. Getting a little dicey there, U5.
Yeah.
But what is the button? I mean, it was a little expensive on their end, sure, but ultimately they get the round and they get the security of if you win one more, it's over. But the utility is gonna suffer too much. I'm doing me a thinking.
And doing the economy math, the alt economy as well. They used what? Orbital Strike and Nightfall into that entire fight.
Time out. Wait. Mm-hmm. Yeah, I'm like trying to think about it. Saying brain function.
That's all right. I mean, Fancy, this timeout as well is also a break, a thinker for them to stabilize. Match point is one of those things where, okay, we're so close, but we cannot afford mistakes. What do we have? What can we use for this next round? I wonder. They have a lot.
Wonder no further.
Yep.
To be fair, this is not too bad. I mean,
yep.
The real issue here is that they're not going to be able to stay in the fight for as long as they would if they had that extra 25 HP plus.
Yeah.
A lot of the utility that can chip them away is going to be that much more lethal, but that's probably the...
Molotovs.
Have overdrive, so it's kind of okay.
They're investing everything. Look at that stun! Beautiful by Nia, but Riza there for the trade. Here comes the dimensional drift about to expire. Using everything to keep them busy! And Riza! Look at that play! Insane! Unable to remove the grab net, so they take advantage. 2v2, very crucial! The smoke dissipates! So yes, I can! It immediately pulls the trigger. Doctor has a Molly, has one smoke left. No plant just yet. Foxy has annihilation. Once they get the doctor, it's out of the question. They need to identify where the last player is to take this 9-12 as the doctor surgically removes and identifies where the problem is into the site. Eliminates the one. Annihilation angle. Here it is. And they remove the last player alive. And it is going to be a slow climax to the end of the round, but it's not over just yet. You five and Fancy, you're going at it some more.
Does he have a clear shot?
Yep.
Oh, at least. Anyway, I feel like you five maybe had the luxury of trying to use that hit to cross into the site. They know once that suppress is going to hit him, all that utility is going to be out the window. Now Fancy. I'm so glad I picked Fancy in my pick.
Ugh.
She's tired of it, guys. She's so tired of it.
Rav is so funny.
Yeah, right.
But that is the call. Fancy doing Raf jumping from one prediction to another. For the context of my reaction, by the way, for those of you that just joined the stream.
That is not true. I will not stand for this slander. I am not one for, you know, wishy-washy opinions here.
We'll see later as Twilight's still not stopping. Beautiful Flash. You know, upon request, that's what we were looking for. And now they've been proactively just using a lot of these heavy utility.
I was about to say, wouldn't it be crazy if we have two bind maps and on an eco? But it doesn't seem like that's the case. The doctor's still here. Oh, man.
Spike down A.
I know, exactly. And they're pushing right in. That's a lot of damage already, but at the end of the day, Mark L, the only one left with a ghost in hand. And here we go. Here we go, Rav. Two more rounds before we go overtime.
Uh-oh. Zoink, Scoob. They have to do something now. I mean, they will have the allowance to buy up. Bradley didn't force anything out. The doctor getting two. I think a value point here is that it might be closer to the orbital strike. That could be useful on the retake. Look at that. Look at all this utility they're hoarding. Viper's Pit maybe could be expended to just put a doorstop. I think he might do it now for Hookah, actually. Yeah. I'm wrong.
There's a lot. Riza's, get one kill, get Nightfall. Maybe you have a lot for retake potential as well. Maybe pick potential. We'll see. Siring ready for the flash, by the way. But Riza already backed away, so they're not going to be playing off from that. It's just a threat for now.
Oh. I think tension is building up for both these teams. They know this is a focal point. Fancy. More and more do they have a chance at coming back on bind. Meanwhile, U5, maybe they're getting too antsy. Maybe they're getting caught by the blinders, you know? Like, oh guys, we just need one more round. You know, they're playing a little unsafe.
Yep.
Time.
Oh, crash now.
You want to
activated
fight it.
By flaring. Caustic Divide activated as well. Nia. Oh, there's a note. There's a person to the right. Even crosses the entry point. Gets a double. Important frag by Fixie before he goes down.
30
Caustic
seconds
Divide. I have no idea what's going on the other side. His doctor will stay put. But the crouch and the firing from Cruz is going to finish the job. Fury V3. Still very close. Twilight is now in enemy territory. Lamps crossing through. 13 seconds on the clock. Faring changes position onto Heaven.
10 seconds
they're gonna
left.
Get the plant down and spike get it down planted. Successfully. They spot out one. They know one is a Lamps player. Will this be over? Will this be 11-12? Nightfall now activated. Foxy, the only one left to clutch this out and send them to the next, but that's gonna be a no. An unsigned 5 will win bind, making this a 1-0 into this
Defenders.
BO3 series.
I gotta say, that was dangerously close to dropping the map, and we have unsigned 5. We'll be trying to deny a post plan, maybe even block off elbow, make the retake that much harder. Are you going to let Twilight be the one to play an active anti-flank? Because after the recon dart, after the drone, he's essentially like another fragging agent. So once again, so many possibilities that could happen. So many things we like to theory craft. Can Fancy United execute?
I feel like while you don't have a cipher, usually we get to see Astra players either play very far back, play on spawn. So technically you have a human ward, if you will. Then yes, I can join the fray and play with the team. But let's take a look at that. Nia, not even gonna wait at all. The paranoia is gonna hit. but it won't stop this onslaught. Flaring with a good trade as well as a triple. What is that? He just stood there and took a lot of these precise shots. Doctor gonna use the smoke. Oh, not to flash anyone, but it doesn't matter. His flaring is right there for the trade immediately. And look at that, U5 again wins the pistol in a blink of an eye once more.
That is three rounds in a row now where U5 get a 4K on the opening pistol. So I think that's a neat little stat. But
yep,
Fancy have shown that they can recover really late into the game. But I hope they don't wait that long, honestly.
Yeah. It's it's definitely really the pistol rounds are just so scary on U5.
Ooh, I do want to see the Vice come into play here because she does have a lot of interesting utility. A Sentinel with the flash plus the wall plus the barbed
wire. The vines, yeah.
Yeah, the vines. I forgot what they're called, actually.
Good question. Razor Vine.
I thought so. Like, it's Razor Vine, right?
Yep. Very sharp.
Big yes. Indeed they are. Yeah. Another concern for me here is that with the Vice in play, how does U5 approach the sites? Because obviously the Steel Garden is going to provide a lot of problems. You know, it won't stop the pistols, but you effectively reduce the round to an eco round for the opposing team.
It's really good at post-plant as well. Flaring, let's see. With the flash on Dizzy, flaring has been so effective, so significant in a lot of these opening rounds. And Markel with a peek, taking the vice, player down. And that's a triple. Just all according to plan here on the anti-eco as U5 takes it 2-0.
They have a Vandal in hand too.
Yeah.
But they managed to keep that in check. I'm thinking maybe Fancy, since they have a lot of these guns. Again, it's just a lot of things you can throw out.
Yeah.
But it's not really catching too many of the U5 players. Perhaps they have that scouted. I would not be surprised if there's a Paranoia play here, getting into a Dizzy play. But maybe Fancy are aware
of
this.
I'm out of here.
Maybe. As Fixie is already there for the angle fast lane. Oh, can't see a single thing, but it don't matter at all. Finds the head nonetheless. And flaring, could you repeat, replicate what you've done in the past? Literally, 5 minutes ago. The doctor's gonna use the smoke again. Nia finds him though. And now it's all up to the sheriff and ghost players. Oh, sheer.
Spike planted.
That's really annoying.
Is that the name?
Yeah.
Last player standing.
I'm not sure if it pushes you upwards too if you stand on top of it for too long. I think it does, right?
It should be able to, yeah.
Either way, this is a round that's unsurprising for most of us. Fancy.
The winds shift in our favor.
They're not really lurky, honestly. Once again, they're going for the same thing. Hey, we find a site, let's commit. If we can fight it out, cool. If we can't, then no. U5. Slow start for Pixie. He's been first point of contact for some of these fights and honestly has been taking the brunt of the utility, which is honestly more than enough to play duelist. Sometimes you just have to take that space and just make them burn utility. Make it expensive to frag you out of the round. At the same time, normally we see the Cyphers kind of juggle between the sites, but Mark L has been stable towards the site.
Yeah. Quite unstoppable, if you will. And Nia, same thing can be said for him. As yes, I can actually came from behind. And now flaring doesn't have an angle. That's why I wasn't able to take down. Yes, I can. Now flaring trapped in the middle of nowhere. 2v2. Now forest out. Overdrive now activated. Laser fingers at the ready. And now they're going to get the plant down.
Spike planted.
You know how your parents tell you not to point because it's rude?
Yep.
Neon.
Why not all five fingers?
Yeah. It's like, what is the logic in that?
It is quite rude, though.
Oh, it is. It'd be very strange, especially without context, but yeah. 2v2. Even fight.
Let's see. Not gonna even use
one enemy
the dart. Because Nia knows where you are as well. Now here comes the peak. Finds the head. Beautifully done. A much better start for Fancy over here on Sunset.
Indeed it is. Especially when the last one was what? 7, 8 unanswered rounds. Now we will have to go on an eco on the side of unsigned 5. They do have a thrash available, so they can be a bit proactive with that. I feel like it's better to use it while it's early rather than let it sit in your inventory for too long. Another thing the teams have not been doing is trying to get mid.
I'd rather win.
I saw Markel walk up for free a bunch of times now, but maybe Fancy has different ideas. Maybe this is the adjustment.
Yeah, I mean, they've been successfully just casually walk into elbow, and that's really practically enough for them to take control of A, but they decide, okay, we're not going to overuse that card. We're not going to overuse that strat too much. Or maybe, let's delay it and use it again.
Yeah, save it for a rainy day. Not waiting for thunder clouds to form, though, as they might catch up one of the defenders here.
Yeah.
Go, go, go!
Moves Fixie out of the equation. Again, it has been elbow that's been the constant threat for U5. Ah, unable to get the kill! Oh, he's so much Twilight gets a peek. Doctor still in the equation until he is out. Flaring and Markel again, the only ones left once more. Gets a headshot onto Nia, but Foxy will end the round nonetheless. Fancy now in the lead for the first time in this series.
Very expensive, bro. Mm-hmm. Very expensive. But either way, you have Steel Garden here. They could use this to brute force a site. Considering that Markel has not moved from B to A, this could be a good read on his end, because now he's finally setting this up. This could give them the extra boost if ever Steel Garden does decide, or rather, yes, I can, deciding to use Steel Garden. Other than that, the 5 are spread out 2-1-2. Don't have a quick rotate in hand, but this could spell disaster regardless of the weapon advantage on A site.
Yeah, I love this adjustment from U5, actually. We're losing elbow constantly, maybe like, what, 4 rounds in a row? Might as well give that up, go for a different angle instead, and then play retake, as we always lose members so early.
How early is too early?
Good
question. I feel like
question.
The first one stats, too, were indicative of how some of these rounds went, because I think U5 had a way higher first blood conversion in comparison to Fancy, all things considered. Now, wow, good read on Fancy's answer. Like, I think they scouted out more resistance, maybe the cam sound. So they pull attention again.
You watch it, find it!
Going drone.
Yeah, look at this fake cosmic divide to just make them think they're going to B. Oh. Did they read? They read the fake, I think. Around
30 seconds left.
30 seconds on the clock. There's the lineup from the vines as Nia gets the execute down, but there's just a lot of smokes. Line of sight locker just really being a nuisance here. Ally with a crossfire with the doctor.
That
might be Steel Garden. Now utilized. I don't think anyone was tagged at all. Not at all. And they still have all their weapons kept as Twilight gets a kill onto flaring. Markel as well. Along the site with a crouch and a fire. And 3v2 now. The clock is ticking. And yes, I can get a kill and Twilight with a triple. All up to Riza. Multi frags here and there. Process of elimination. Oh, the dart's gonna give him away. So no element of surprise anymore. There's a smoke. There's a tap on the spike. Sees the legs of the spray. It's not gonna work out for you as Twilight lands a 4K and demolishes U5 in that round.
4K for Twilight for round number 4. Fancy United looking a bit more dominant this time around. Meanwhile, U5 maybe frozen in the water? Question mark. L. Fancy though. You know what I like the most? Actually, no. What I was worried about was maybe they were overplaying their hand. They already had 2 clear sights. They went back and forth, back and forth. It did work out eventually, but once again, that's the looming threat of having a complex set play. There's a lot of moving parts that can misfire.
Yeah, it's very hard to delay layering ultimates, you get to see Steel Garden and Cosmic Divine used for more of a macro approach rather than something used for micro. And I feel like, you know, that's just really cool. Call. Oh, Riza! Just really catching them off guard. You talked about this, Raph, that mid control being given up.
Mm-hmm. I think he wants to get the Vandal, but fancy have a good read here. They want to maintain this economy and Pixie. Oh, goodness. Finds another straight pick. And Reza gets one mid before they can retaliate. Oh, my.
And Pixie gets the upgrade as well on that Vandal. Meanwhile, Cruz sneaking his way in already onto B. Do they know this? That's the question. There's no camera or anything of that sort. So this could potentially be really good for Fancy if they're able to take one more player out of the equation. Cruz, Markel, 1v1 gets the Cypher player down.
Now I have Vandals just from the picked up weapon.
One enemy remaining.
What? Wow, no need for a Vandal when the Bucky can do just about the same.
Exactly. Oh, that's gonna be a bit of a slow thrash. Able to get the kill down. Satchel in, yes I can! Still takes advantage of that Art Rose for the flash, but the very scary penguin is on the way to you. Now he's down the lineup. Oh, that's gonna be a... What is that? Yes, I can! And with the clutch, he's even like scratching his head. How did that happen? The lineup might not have happened, but the jiggle peaks from Yes, I Can was proven to be effective.
I feel like that was a perfect storm of everything that could go wrong on the side of U5.
Yeah.
They had the read on where Yes I Can was backpedaling, but again, Pixie not getting the timing in it, and then suddenly they don't use Wingman to go for the defuse. It's fumble after fumble, and U5 looking a little lost. Yeah. I mean, it wasn't eco, so like anything at that point was a bonus. Still.
Thought that was gonna be a showstopper into a double kill. Yes, again, good read, still expecting another player, but Riza, because I shots, tries to hide through the corner, but Foxy, I thought that was gonna be a fumble, just as you said, but Doctor really taking advantage. Foxy has to guard the spike, but no, Mark L ready for this, and U5 breaks the streak of Fancy.
I need to sit back up.
The gap does not look that big now, but Fancy, they have a lot of money to work with. They're just gonna try and play the long game now. If they can maintain like maybe a 7-round lead for the foreseeable future, or rather if they get 7 rounds, I think this is already a good half. U5, actually wait, do I feel like 7 is enough for Fancy, who doesn't have like a dedicated sentinel?
This goes here.
We'll have to see.
Yeah. Is indeed in question. They have a lot of ultimates in the bag for this round. Even if they have one Cruz not having their Cosmic Divine.
Ew.
What is that shot? That was nasty.
This way. Here we go.
Hey.
Okay, well, that doesn't stop the sprint, but hey, that's info.
Yep, very, very good info as Riza finds the tail end of Nia. Now forces to go back as Riza, beautiful pick once more. Now, they don't have a lot of advantage at the moment as Andre's Fury now activated, but the plant is going to be denied as Cruz still holds the angle onto Boba. And here comes the Steel Garden to prevent them from entering through. Planted. They still get to keep their weapons as they're able to back away. Rolling thunder, it's still not over. Ult. Now the Art Rose gonna use for the flash, and Yes, I Can alongside Foxy. Now it's all up to the Doctor. They didn't!
They
He's
didn't
gonna stick through the spike, but he actually loses it! Oh my gosh, they're spraying! Wow. And look at Yes, I Can even jumping to dodge the shots. It's Fancy quick thinking. Whoa! Now I'm like, what could have happened?
I
if
can't
he stuck
this.
It. Yeah.
Yeah, because he was on the left side anyway, so the spray wasn't going to hit him. Oh my goodness. A lot of funny things happening in this map. And over ulting, potentially. They used the Nightfall, but Bright. It did get 2 more orbs out of that investment.
Hunter's Fury is still very much up, so this post fight won't really lose any strength. E5. They changed configuration. They have been pretty decently successful with the sheriffs in hand. But they have to fight their way back here. We don't want to see
them
lose a series lead because of a few bad rounds. Again, mental strength is as much as physical strength.
Yeah, two important parts of the story. Fancy. Really loving their lead. Especially that U5, again, is on an eco. It's going to be an A-main fight. This with the drone fixing already pretty much tag slides in. Via a beautiful shot once more. The layering of utilities. Having to surgically remove every single one. Maybe the doctor has a different plan. Unfortunately, it's too far. Look at the flash. Foxy with a jump shot on that shorty. And Fancy, they're really doing amazing on this first half.
Didn't see me coming.
Didn't even save up anything there. So now you fly and play from behind. Fancy, I like the comeback here. I'm trying to think, what can U5 do at this point? They had a lot of engagements where, as long as they get first blood, it's a decently easy convertible round. But now Fancy, they're just kind of playing hardball with them. We're not going to lurk. We're not going to do anything too crazy. We are going to run at you, and you're going to have to duel us in, in an honest way. Or as honest as throwing a lot of flashes and stuns are. You get the point.
It's really the A main control that's been just constantly demolished by Fancy. And no hold whatsoever. But we'll see. The approach is very different this time around. The fast lane going through. The barbed wire. The razor vines for more space. Mia, again, getting so much for the side of Fancy. Miguel getting a kill, but I don't know how important that is at this point. What is that? Fancy! Able mid slide as yes I can with a peek again. He's on fire. And all of that, all for naught, as Fancy again wins another round.
Last round in the half.
Indeed, he is on fire, but U5 castle they built is in flames and not in a good way. Fancy, they're looking to maybe play the game of attrition here. Maybe game one was to wear out U5. And so far, Pixie's just not having a good game here. We were kind of touting him to be a focal point for this U5 squad. And right now, that maybe that expectation is just a bit too much to carry on his shoulders. He needs to have a better second half here to keep U5 from entirely sinking.
Yeah, this, we talked about the weakness of A-main, right? A-main and elbow constantly. You get to see the moving parts being constantly being repositioned, okay? Get the operator, Fixie, you go market. Nothing's happening. Okay, elbow is always constantly being dominated. Go to Link, maybe top mid, maybe. That's something that you can do. But so far, it has been such a big straightforward approach by Fancy, but with many layers.
Layer upon layer, hopefully they have the correct names on those so they don't get lost and they don't draw on the wrong one. Fancy again, going for that slower approach.
They're trying a crossfire, but Twilight again, right or left, it has always been the correct answer. As Doctor just trying to salvage elbow, is now shutted down by Twilight. Still good damage on the board with 3v3, and there's a star that's going to expire.
Spike down.
And Twilight
A
has been huge in a lot of these rounds.
Left.
Maybe finding a 4K even from Link, as Riza still has a scan in his pocket, but decides to just not use it.
Oh, no.
I'm gonna push the side, the jump. Twilight knows the information. 2v1 situation. Let's see how Twilight's gonna play this one out, and nope. There we go. It is gonna be an 8-4 first half of this, Raph.
Oh boy. I'm glad that there's a small bounce back here by you.
Switching sides.
Fancy.
At the second half of this sunset map, Fancy still in a big lead, but U5 maybe they're more comfortable in attack. Unless we're going to Abyss.
I mean, you did say just in our little break there that U5 could be a bit more impressive on attack. Mm. I would not be surprised. Again, Fancy just don't have that hard doorstop
Someone acquired.
Mike's digging. Thanks, little man.
Yep.
How easy it was for them to walk onto site and get a plant.
Unless this retake might be considerably scary. Fixie with a double. A beautiful start on this hold, unless Twilight has something to say about it. Clearing is so low now as Mia has a very important kill. Surgically removing every single member. As Markel is the only one left here in a very awkward angle. Uncovered. No coverage at all as they beak together. And Fancy will take this 9-4 here with a beautiful pistol start.
Well, unless Q5 get an insane eco here, I think Fancy are touted to be the first to hit double digits on this map. And that being said, I think the more we mention Abyss, the closer we get to Abyss.
The more you mention something, it will truly be summoned.
Give me a gigantic bag of gold.
1 million.
Gold?
Gold.
What type of gold? Just gold.
Gold is gold. Yeah, here we go. Fancy, again, buying a lot of guardians in their bank. But this time, U5's gonna take the mid approach.
Like
right
it.
Here.
I like it a lot. They know they have weapons to leverage. But once again, these closer angles have to be something that they consider. They could die to one massive shot guard too.
Exactly that, and it's just a complete enclosement in the mid, at the mid area of Sunset. They were surrounded. I wouldn't know where to look either.
Definitely not at the breach flash. That is something you have to avoid. I'm trying to formulate an opinion on why taking mid with an eco, not great. Yeah, you got the space, but what happens then when you have to, you know, plant your feet and maybe brawl a little bit? Kind of have to worry about tiles if it does get overtaken. Worry about market, because there's always going to be a player peering from that angle. And Cruz firing off a few sheriff shots here, maybe to sell something. Hell does have a gap to work with. He does get one for his trouble.
A really important pick here, but Twilight constantly, no matter what weapon he uses, he's just a constant problem for U5. They are able to get the post plant down, but post plant has been a bit questionable in the first second half.
Need to have it. And I feel like we're still gonna continue with that threat. As long as they're burning time, but Nia, come on.
Done by the doctor. Still unable to leave the Twilight with a flank! They didn't identify it at all! And they have the Cypher to boot! That is ouch! That was their bonus.
It was. And pardon me, lady. I am coughing at sheer awe of Fancy. You see what I mean? When there's no real anti-flag, you cannot be unattentive. That was very unfortunate on the side of on U5. They have a tripwire.
Yeah, they do. Exactly. It's so.
Oh dear.
Must be pain. The fact that the vice is on the other side as well.
You know, yes, I can. I didn't realize he was going 15-7. Everybody has been performing, especially Twilight. We talk about how instrumental Twilight has been for that offense. Now, even on the defense, he's been really, really good. The timing on his utility has been great. And that was back-to-back 4Ks too. Not just from him, but from the rest of the team to really hammer this home. Oh no. U5 getting caught in no man's land yet again.
Might consider to play a bit far back, knowing that he has ult and 6 HP. So, might just relax, wait for the next move. But look, he's actually peeking market.
What is for sale in the market? Hopefully not the life of one of your teammates. As U5's trying to find some meaningful control here. Oh, I like the patience of Iriza. Finds one. That's what he gets, though.
I can't believe we're watching this. Is it going to be a knife? Nope.
Oh, no.
Still trying to look. Yep. Riza. Trying to find the right timing. Oh, dear. Nope. Waiting for a scope. ADS. Still very patient. Oh, no! I think Riza low-key panicked for just split second.
30 seconds left.
You know, they moved after a bit of time. 20 seconds on the clock, though. Here comes the spike. But Hunter's Fury now utilizes Fox. He has eyes on Boba. Here comes the squad. Riza, the only one here. The slide trying to find his shot, his mark. The blind is just too much. As Nia again finds another important kill. As Flurry, trying his best, finds the second.
Your first mistake.
And you five still hanging on in this map.
Five's trying to get as many rounds as possible to just kind of chip away at the economy of Fancy now. I thought for sure they would stagger that Hunter's Fury a little bit better because time was winding down and they did have a few more bits of utility to delay that even more. A small lapse of judgment on the side of Fancy, giving just a little bit of room for U5 to work it. They do have that neural theft, so straight pick could mean anything at this point. Flaring. After winning that clutch, managed to farm up enough for a thrash. And it does look like it's going to be an immediate hit towards B.
Oh, actually gets one. And that's Twilight, the most important player so far.
I know exactly.
In this sunset. But Crew says, nope, it could be me as well. I have Cosmic Divide now. I see the spike. Markel going towards Market. Overdrive activated. Now has to dash. Dash the stun. But can't dash the laser. Hands from the side of Nia and Fancy now at match point.
Match point.
Does look like we are getting teamed more and more for Abyss. And Fancy, once again, great recovery there. They saw one of their members get caught up by the thrash, but what does this mean for U5? They can't force up anything other than one rifle. I have a Hunter's Fury and from the shadows alongside with Pixie's Showstopper. Gonna work in conjunction of each other. No Fancy. All they have to do is just wait this out realistically.
Yeah, they have so much advantage, including the Cosmic Divide, the guns. It just looks like we might go to Abyss unless U5 finally attacks A.
Well, that is a gap that they could manage to sneak into. But the rethink ability by MCY is something that is gonna be a problem. So Cosmic Divide to block off, maybe in mid. Pixie's desperately trying to get a pick here, but doesn't even get damage off that Showstopper. So Fancy, the woes are still not ended.
Yep, not at all. Looks like it's gonna be a front-to-back approach here. No flank whatsoever as Riza uses the Hunter's Fury. Flaring gets a kill onto Nia. Beautiful tag as Yes I Can and Foxy double up. And look at this though. Fancy seems to be on the way to Abyss, taking U5 alongside with them. And that's gonna be a kill from Doctor. The Stinger in hand, but that's gonna be a no. We're going to map number 3, everybody.
Well, well, well.
Well, well, well.
So that's 3 roles that he's occupied. Meanwhile, outside of Fancy, he could say the same about Yes I Can.
True.
What did Yes I Can play on the first map? I can't seem to remember.
He can play Sentinel, Initiator, and now he's a controller.
Well, you ask him, what role can you play? Or can you play this role? His answer is yes, he can.
Yes. Yeah, so I can!
Yes. I can. Ah.
Here we go. It is the beginning. Fancy on your attacking side first. U5 on defend. Let's see.
That was a JoJo reference.
Oops. Maybe. Oh! Here comes the stun as Riza. Not gonna get that transfer though as they go back, but here comes a second flash. Once more, the absolute aggressiveness of U5 might be paying off here.
I feel like that has to be the case for Abyss. I mean, it is a really big map that if you really wanted to default it out, that's just so much space. The breach and clear and just kind of like throw out so much of your utility. So inherently, it's a very expensive map to maneuver unless you are willing to wager your own life. U5... But yeah, let's not make them guess too much. Let's just outright fight them before they can enter the gates. Let's see if they can adjust. Nia.
Crown this man.
One enemy remaining.
Yeah, in, yeah, out. Fixie is online, baby. And that's exactly what we've been looking for and waiting for from U5 since we saw them on Bind today.
You know, it's crazy. That's the first time we didn't see a 4K on the opening round.
True. Well, the second time now in the series, I suppose, on pistol.
No, because first one we had Fixie.
Yeah.
4K. And then the second half we had. Well, it was Fixie again.
Yeah, it's right? Fixie again. Yeah, exactly, exactly.
And then we had U5 go for a 4K that courtesy of Larry. In that previous map.
Mark.
Okay, now my memory is failing. Like, I'm missing
okay.
who the second half 4K belonged to, but I'm sure it was there.
I'm sure it was Fixie all over again. And I feel
Was it not Twilight?
Oh, it was Twilight. That's true. Fixie bind Twilight on Sunset, and now back to Fixie over here on Abyss. Yeah.
That's right. The Twilight really leaving his signature scent of success, apparently, on that previous map. Hopefully he can perfume Abyss the same way. Larry had the timing on that.
Concealment.
Having to activate a star as well. Neo gonna dash right into B. Really having complete control despite being eco. It's just a bunch of classics, by the way. So getting the plant down is already a big bonus.
How big? I mean, fancy they have to retake here with a bunch of scope weapons. Obviously, one hit to the body is super enticing. But I see.
Standing ahead.
And the Spectre are gonna get obliterated. Hello?
Oh my gosh, Spectre from that range might not be in play as Fixie. That outlaw is gonna do the job. But they're so expensive. 2v2 now. There's time
one
is
enemy
ticking.
Wow.
The classic headshot. Where's the dash away? Even holds base bar to float from the sky. But guess what? There's a crossfire happening. Even if they die, it's totally fine. They're just wearing a bunch of plastic anyways.
Together.
Nope.
You can't fall apart
what now. Is happening?
That is actually mayhem.
Yeah.
I would have never expected them to win in that fashion, especially with a classic. I mean, range was dominated, obviously, by the weaponry of Unsigned 5. But hey, here we are.
That
again,
saves
I'm
so
just,
much money.
Yeah, like, what would be the call there? I mean, if they had the VOD review, how did they even lose that fight? Was Nia just that accurate? I mean, yeah, it can happen, but that's a classic, so that's a lot of time before you will eventually fall to the left flank.
It could be, but what you said, right? Like, they're playing close range and throwing a lot of scoped weapons. Maybe it could be that. Fancy. Yeah, you did. You did.
I did say that. Yeah. Oh well.
A main was the problem earlier. No, that it's not a lot of threat with Eco at the hands of U5.
I am now very curious how they want to take mid if ever that comes into fruition, because now the defensive aggression on the side of U5 is nowhere to be seen. Despite having the sheriffs, I think this would be the perfect round to be aggressive actually. I don't want to gamble against the fact that there are a bunch of rifles here. At the very least, the Guardian and all sandals across the board. Again, Fancy United keeping it simple. Entry, frag, plant.
One enemy remaining.
Yeah, it feels like that's the flowchart that Fancy is following right now. I mean, it is the very... Is this eco? Let's go!
Long.
On the rope! Just in time, gets to save his weapon. Everyone gets to take all the weapons on round number 4.
Keep them in our sights.
I don't know, Rico. This seems like Fancy could be running away with this, especially with how Sunset panned out.
Yeah, I agree with you there. The fact that they were able to win through the sheer power of the classics. No one was carrying anything else. B site was completely free. Maybe this could be a different story. There's the Astra star setups and the tripwire. So let's see.
There's so much things to slow this fight down. I mean,
blocking vision concealment.
The thing is, Blair probably shouldn't be the one. There's so much utility that he gets wasted, but hey, either way, he gets the frags.
Either way, Doctor is right there to save that angle as well. Beautifully done, but Twilight just really pushing through a lot of these angles. So brave. So precise with his aim as well. He's getting taken down by Mark L at the end of the day. Remember, it's an operator. They don't want to waste this this buy. Now it's a 2v2. Plant's still not there. He's using it as bait. The waves are not high enough for them to conceal themselves. As Foxy is going to wrap around. I think he spotted at the very last second. And now has to take the spike elsewhere.
That is a long jog away. Like you mentioned, that is the fake. Do they bite? Do they bite? Oh my gosh.
They actually bite.
Wow.
That's crazy. Oh. Okay, Markel is staying.
Wait, but this could be a disaster because either way, it's a 1v1.
30 seconds left.
Oh, no! I feel like he's planted.
My Filipino came out. 70 HP, Foxy. Let's see though. Already spots the one from tower. Actually gets closer, peeking for information.
Like
just crawling. But the jumping's gonna spot him out, actually.
No
way! What a transfer, Foxy! What a clutch from this man!
Absolute destruction on the side of Fancy. And you five have no idea what hit him, Riku. Oh, good lord.
I thought Fixie saw him! The jump peek earlier!
Clutch.
Papa. Papa, if you deserve it.
Yep, Foxy.
Oh my goodness.
Foxy having the time of his life now, man.
That's a violation. You can't do it. Oh my gosh.
Revealing
that's
area.
Disgusting. But then again, like, that's a testament to how inclined everybody is, not just keeping it cool in the clutch situation. Because on paper, yes, he did avoid the sightlines, and I think that was a great read. In general, what if a player was coming from the left box? What if Mark L wasn't playing in that position? You know? I like it. The spray of confidence.
Yep.
Oh, no.
Oh, could be a double of swing here. Good coordination, but Nia dodges. There's one. Yes, I can. And also double swing alongside Mia as well. Doesn't get the outburst off. Ariza does, but yes, I can. He's gonna get this spray down. Bit tagged up though.
One
but
enemy
still
remaining.
Fancy in the lead.
Convincing lead too. Wow. Fixie had a freebie there. Not so quick. Not so charitable as Fancy. At 1-4 on Abyss. My. What can you five do? And how quickly can they do it, Riku?
I mean, they look so confident. They look so coordinated. And not only as a team, right? Not only layering the lineups, having to clear very important corners on B, but also their individual plays. Honestly, they're really impressive to watch. As Fixie just trying to grapple on some of these opportunities, but they just slip away.
I suggest grip you just move. Is not there. That control that they would have loved to have in the earlier portions of not just this map, but Sunset as well.
Gosh, beautiful flash there, but the knives are not finding their mark. And U5 might just take advantage of that. Spike now planted. And they're trying to wrap around. They're all inside the site. Riza, look at this crossfire between the U5 players.
One enemy
last
remaining.
One out is gone. And there we go. U5 breaks momentum. Fancy.
I'm so surprised they actually risked Twilight in that situation. They could have backpedaled and played far removed from the plant itself. Just kind of leveraged off that Hunter's Fury. But Fancy felt like they had the momentum to keep it going. So fair call, fair play. At the same time, they have allowed Five to gather up enough resources for another Cosmic Divide and a Rolling Thunder, aka Nightfall but bright. So Fancy, they do retain those ults, but I still feel like that was a round they should have won.
I just can't stop thinking about, like, dark mode, nightfall, light mode, Fixie finds Cruz, an unexpected angle, trying to lurk at the...
I feel like there are certain parallels that we can't draw.
Mm-hmm.
Now utility is flood through. The question is, can you 5-hold this?
Let's see. Nia didn't see flaring onto the right side. Finds the spike lander. As Dr. Down gets kill onto. Yes, I can. Things are falling apart. A might not be the answer in this multiple choice.
Just go all of the above.
All of the above.
Yeah, D for default. Maybe this is where they try to, you know, slice up the map. There is a lot of room to cover. But the way Fancy have been operating is that they will operate as a 5, they will execute as a 5, and just kind of play off the strength of trades, which again has its own drawbacks, has its own strength. U5 though, like, they're a bit more open to exploring these configurations. At the same time, you never know which player is going to land a few crazy clips themselves.
Here.
Yeah. Plays could be coming from many, many different players. We've seen so much work done. Fixie also, a lot of his moments from Bind, even at the beginning of this map. But now they're holding back. They're not revealing too much. I don't think they saw the one from Spawn, though. But they're pulling away anyways.
Now they have to change the tempo here. Something was not working for Fancy. So... I like that they are shuffling the deck at the moment, maybe burning a few resources here and there. Fixie has been droned out though, but that Hunter's Fury has just been halfway sitting in Twilight's backpack for a few rounds. Cruz, mobility, even from the shadows.
Still pulling them in.
Yeah, not at all. Nice. Pre-firing from flaring, knowing that's always the place that the jet is going to land after flying across the sky.
30 seconds left.
Now there's the plant. Hunter's Fury activated to prevent that from going down as well. Frieza, really good tags from Cruz, and I can. And flaring, all he has to do is follow up. But with Hunter's Fury themselves and Foxy takes advantage, they have the spike down already. So now they're holding on out. This could be a little bit deja vu for Fancy players, as they've been constantly winning this side, as Markel is going to try his best to use the waves to his advantage. Now, he's going to give information with his fault line. Taps the spike. Going to look at Bridge with a double swing from Fancy, and then just take back this round for themselves.
Go B, dude. I feel like is the call. If Fancy were to lose that, I think it would be the right time to call a timeout and sort over, you know, what has been working. What do we have? Let's take it into stock. Hunter's Fury both being expended, but I do believe that Flank does have the better team fighting ult at the moment. Cosmic Divide. So look at that. They now put both utility heavy agents towards B. Fancy being stubborn, they go for a mid take here. Maybe they go for a B split, but it is a 1-3-1 default instead.
They did something very similar earlier. They buy their time.
Headshot.
Is that collatable? Yes, it is. Fixie took the aim. There it is. That's not a word. I know.
Collatable.
Collatable. Sounds nice, though.
Not a word. I mean, are these walls thin enough? Is it penetrable, Riku?
Yeah, true. That's the word I'm looking for. Thank you. Collatable.
Oh, wait. No, it is a word.
Is? We know. Nia. Playing around the smoke. Markel anticipates.
One enemy remaining.
That's the play in mind, and things are falling apart on the side of Fancy already. They get to keep all their guns, maybe. As Yes I Can is the only one left. Shot caller, the IGL. Fancy able to do much, surrounded by the rest of U5. Area.
If you're not a good shot today,
just don't go B, bro. Don't listen. But again, adjustments. I think that's the name of the game. I'm really surprised why Twilight decided to go for an ability that would make him immobile.
Yep.
At the same time, it's one of those heat of the moment things. Honestly, I didn't even know that was a penetrable wall.
Yeah, it looks really impenetrable. It looks really thick, you know what I mean?
It looks solid.
It looks solid, like, yes. Yeah.
Also,
looks like it has a lot of layers.
Yeah, the word is actually, I think, closer to collate.
You know,
right? Like bring things together, not actually like collateral. But
oh, okay. I have understanding. We talked about how A might not be the best option for Fancy, but it's like they want to try again. They want to make this right. But Reza just shuts down the duelist. They're not even as close. Spike is already down. They're completely dominated by the rest of U5, and now it's even.
So A, despite everything, still not is a good look.
Mm-hmm.
Fancy.
Nope.
And I think partly because, again, they're just not playing the role of the lurk. They're not dividing the attention enough. Now U5 have a decent setup towards B that has proven to be difficult for Fancy. Because right now it just looks like, well, that didn't work. Let's go to the opposite side. And I don't think this is the best line of thinking at this level of play. But kudos to them for keeping it simple.
I suggest you move!
Shadows traveling.
Yeah, keeping it simple is definitely going to be. It has been working out in their favor. Nia is going to go right, actually, past, not on top anymore. It has been incredibly predictable. And therefore, they're changing the menu as Yes I Can takes down Flaring, Mark Allen, and Riza. Quite far away. So they're going to go through many different paths. Quite far away, no crossfire whatsoever. Flash at the ready is Riza with a jiggle peek. Quite effective. And Mark Allen actually playing up the fire a little bit here, but he's spotted. I think the barrel of his gun is quite exposed. He's a 1v3. Quite difficult. Even utilizing the null command at that, quite worth it if they want to take the revive and take that weapon to the next round.
Last round before the switch.
It's only like two rounds away from halftime,
mm-hmm.
So might as well. And I think they'd welcome any cushion they could get into the second half. Death. It has been decently competitive despite how these rounds are being won. So I'd still say this is up in the air. Bladestorm, very close side of Nia. Does he have the chance to use it? Maybe, maybe not. Operator in the hands of Pixie as he's been having a slow game again. I mean, it's not bad,
yeah,
but in comparison to map one, right?
Camera taken
out. Yeah, I feel like this configuration of staying at A works if U5 goes A, right? But whenever they go B, it almost feels like a done deal for Fancy, and they might go at it again, just like clockwork. Not on top of the platform for Nia, but this time towards more grounded approach. It has been working out. Knives now activated. Hunter's Fury.
Whoa.
Gonna attack them both, actually. Foxy and Nia out of the equation.
Covering it.
But the spike has already been planted. They're in position.
3v3. Operator in hand. Difficult retake for U5. But mm-hmm. they need that extra round to equalize going into the second
Ooh.
Half.
Oh, they've got... Oh my gosh, the Cove is going to get utilized as well, but that's not going to stop them at all. U5 with a Cosmic Divide to end it all on the first half to 6-6.
Let's go!
Oh my goodness. U5, bring it back.
Ooh,
on
side.
Abyss, as Fancy looked like they were going to run away with it.
Fancy and U5 time. At a very crucial series at that only one gets to continue their journey here in VCT SEA.
Oh man, now that you put it that way, there is a lot of line. But now, the doctor will get his head surgically removed by Nia.
Now already gone. As Fixie trying to
spike
find
planted.
Something. Fancy with a quick trigger. Already down, already killing two. As Mark Allen flaring, trying to protect the spike, but with just so much more people alive inside of Fancy, you get confused about where to look. Unless Mark Allen destroys a lot of the members out of the equation here. Narrowing down isolated fights. Nope, denied. Fancy wins another pistol.
No 4K again.
Uh-huh.
Come on, guys.
Was that important?
Yes, it was, Nia. As a matter of fact, thank you, Jet. But we have seen really crazy ecos here, just even on this map alone. I can't believe the second round on this map went the way they did. Nia has been a godsend for Fancy United, as he has been keeping this afloat for the gang. Because right now, I think we are slowly watching the game devolve into a bit of a brawl, and you need that star power to push you over the limit.
Let's see. The limit, as you said, being tested is Fancy. Double Guardian, Outlaw. Mia's gonna use the same position, pushing catwalk. It's Fixie. Gonna dash right through. Maybe spot someone from tower, from Link. There's three members just bring a lot of pre-fire. And the shock dart is about to just destroy Fixie. And no duelist for you. But at least they're able to plant the spike. Nia, Outlaw in hand, sees the shoulder. Dash activated. Just an easy shot. Doctor is out! What is that? That's disgusting! Even though it's an eco, still impressive shots from the side of Nia. 1v2 situation. It's not going to be the jet on top, but it is going to be the harbor. Yes, I can. It's ending that round. Now it's 8-6.
That was a great shot.
Amazing.
And actually, you see how fast Batsy went on that flank? I feel like this was something that U5 was not doing enough of. You know, just trying to wrestle from... back to front.
That was... I'm surprised too, but I want to know what it was.
Sorry, the rhythm is there. Like, the rhythm for us is the same, so I'm just like waiting on... Riku, the shijaku.
So true. Now Stinger Bias, once more on the side of U5, in a row, they're really wanting to push something to happen here.
Oh man. That's the first force by Ray to see.
Spike plant.
Not entirely sure why they would force when rifles are insanely powerful on this map. But hey, if they can make it work, why not?
The doctor is flanking. I repeat. The doctor is flanking. Let's see if this is gonna pay off. I'm gonna try to peek already, but let's take a look at Twilight though. And Foxy Margell and the rest are just gone in an instant. Fancy is just so ready for everything.
Oh man, I have been groaning a lot and I have been sighing a lot, but only because I think U5 dug their own grave on this map. They are not gonna have enough to buy. It was a U5 of Forest. Surprisingly, they do. Wait, no. Math, because they planted twice. Oh, actually, it's three times there. Okay, never mind.
It makes sense. Yes, yes,
yeah.
Yes.
I was just about to say, if they were going to eco now, then that is very, very dangerous. Fancy still have, I would say, an advantage here, just because Yes I Can is one away from ult. At the same time, they still control the rules of engagement here. And so far, U5... Ghost bot is not working out.
Oh, flash. Have a push. Oh, just gonna get... Wait, she wasn't stunned. But at the end of the day, still, that's against three. They've read Fancy with the catwalk push constantly. But Fixie finds another shot. Triple at that. Dash still in the line. About to expire real soon, as Yes I Can finds a beautiful headshot onto Riza. Fixie again. Being so sneaky about this, and Yes I Can, all he had to do was crouch and fire some shots. 3v2 now. Good dodge on the flash.
Oh,
finds the headshot. Decides to go paranoia, 39 HP. But at the end of the day, Markel saves this round for U5.
That's crazy. They landed all the hard shots, but the easy shots just kind of escaped them. And sometimes that's how the cookie crumbles.
Three.
Like I said, right, that is such a precise shot. Hits another decently precise one, and then a completely full blind enemy misses. Fancy United do have another buy in the tank after this. They are going to use the Blade Storm. Only had to just bolster that buy. Unsigned 5. They're not on such ground. They have to be careful. Because once again, Fancy do have the round lead plus the econ lead.
Oh dear. I think Nia's gonna get backstabbed unless they actually decide not to push. They have no information, so it's much better. Unless the doctor has something to say about it. And now Nia is gone.
Well, somehow, some way, the fate of Nia was sealed. Minus one. But again, Blade Storm, so it's all good. And now equalized.
That was
dangerous.
That was dangerous, but it paid off in the end. Cruz uses the cipher cage for the confusion, for the panic. But now, Fancy slowly losing their members left and right. Cruz, though, has an angle, an unexpected one at that. They all look at the same direction. They're busy looking at tower. They don't know. They're unsure. They might be crossfired. Maybe an ace for Cruz on towards this 10th. They had the lead.
Cover going out.
30 seconds left.
I'm more confused. Hey. Well,
wow.
Okay, congrats. But I'm more confused why Vixie just did try to fight the refrag. I think he was a bit too worried about Heaven there.
Yeah.
And, you know, he lost track of it. But now Fancy, three more rounds away from series, unfortunately eliminating Unsigned 5.
One enemy remaining.
In fact, they had the numbers advantage as well until Cruz came into the picture and whittled them down one by one, boiling into an ace. And Fancy now, just as you said, double digits time, and U5.
Get out of my way!
It's a very, very broken bye for them.
This is as broken as they come. Late Storm has to do a lot of the heavy lifting here, paired with Flaring. But Flaring has been awfully quiet this game.
Yep.
This is a big ask.
Okay, Star, not gonna be retrieved, perhaps?
Here comes...
The Reckoning, yes I can! Gets a kill onto Fixie. And now things are falling apart, even though they have the plant! Nia with the flank! Flaring, trying to salvage things. They're gonna be coming from one angle, now they're going to run away! And they're not allowing them at all to retreat! And it's Fancy! 11-7 now, close to match point.
Oh my goodness, I think Cruz is on a bit of a tear here. You saw how sharp his aim has become in the last three rounds or so. And U5 could be 6 feet under very, very soon if this is the trend that's going to keep happening moving forward. A little bit of retaliation from them. But if you look at it this way, Riku, regardless of what weapons U5 had in that round, those duels were just straight up lopsided. U5 just did not have a chance to retaliate. They do have a Rolling Thunder and a Neural Theft alongside a Hunter's Fury. So maybe they could try and battering ground their way towards A, but Nia has other plans.
Wow, the flash, the paranoia, everything, but can't find the second shot. But Foxy, what Foxy says, okay, it's fine, I got this. Mark L retaliates though.
One enemy.
Foxy leans in over again with a swing. Now it's 1v1, pure chaos onto A main. Doctor picks up the spike, but yes, I can. Slowly looming over and is spotted by the Neural Theft.
So long of a travel distance for both players here, so they have to have a good grasp of this guessing game. And it turns out the doctor is gonna have an uncontested plan. What does Yes I Can have for the retake here? It does have
everything, it seems.
Yeah, planted the spike. Minus one task.
Yep. Let's see here. Long travel, but doable. Both Vandal in hand. Coming from tower as well.
I feel like there's actually no way for Doctor to lose this. There's a trip at a cam. The only way he loses this is if he overextends.
Yeah, the fact that you can't use your utility first, you need to know where he's gonna be coming from. There it is. There's the cove. Oh. Is spotted. Top of the spike! Surprise! Oh. Yes, I can! Takes this map to match point!
Oh.
Walls up, man.
I mean, what else could have they done there? The cove was planted down, so he could have halved it if there was no aggression.
the tripwire was eliminated as quickly as possible. Now Fancy are on the brink, exercising those map 1 demons that were the unsigned 5. Still, Rolling Thunder, big team fight, Ultriku.
Yep, they could pick a side. Maybe A seems to be their element so far. Maybe their flank lurk hasn't been panning out too well. Maybe they want to find a pick, a catwalk first. No scan for you. Mia's fine. Marshall in hand. Push through the wave. Beautiful flash, but unable to take the shot.
Maybe there's a little bit of fatigue setting in for Nia. And Fixie's gonna try and take away that hero in the form of Yes I Can in that duel.
Enemy marked.
Two bullets in the outlaw.
Nowhere to run!
Riza finds a kill on the Twilight, but Nia finds Fixie, and it's still pretty much in favor of U5 at the moment, numbers advantage-wise. Oh, Nia might catch? The doctor? They don't see each other! No way!
Oh,
the doctor finds Nia first, though, at the end of the day, and Foxy will follow suit. And U5 are at A, and they're having a fun time.
Fancy straight up not having a good time.
Yeah.
I mean, they do have a lot of leeway here. There's just no way Cruz clutches this out. Fives, they'll keep the Rolling Thunder intact, which I think is still gigantic.
Yeah.
A lot of fights going towards mid. I'm curious, what type of arsenal is allowed on the side of Fancy here? That's really curious. Maybe the model is blocking his vertical view.
Yeah.
But, you know, every now and then it's good to check downwards. Fancy's one away from winning this.
And U5, of course, still quite a climb. Well,
right there.
Quite close for overtime. But they cannot afford any mistake whatsoever. Are they prepared for another catwalk attempt? Inside. Though they've been... Oh, Nia is taking a different approach this time. Going towards the lower ends of mid instead of catwalk. See, they're looking. They have a dash. There's the flash. And it doesn't get the second kill as Riza is prepared for that one for one.
Prepared is a good word to really emphasize how Fancy has been playing. You know, they haven't been panicking at all. It's been decently clean for this Abyss map, but they have to close it out. U5 trying to find whatever lifeline they are allowed, as they really don't want to exit the tournament just yet.
Nope.
Drone out.
At least they know somebody is there. Twilight drops from tower, climbs back up again for a little bit of mental warfare. Foxy, his eyes on A main's entrance. 40 seconds on the clock. Spike's now climbing towards A.
Take flight.
It does look like it's committed. I was about to say they have to work with here.
Yep. Rolling Thunder activated as well.
Left.
What the pre-fire is that? Twilight and a scan to boot. Now they have a lot of things to worry about. They have to look at tower, but he drops down as Flaring gets a kill onto
spike
two.
Down A.
Foxy the only one left with 45. They've been pre-firing the smoke. It's been
Watch
deadly. 13
it.
Seconds on the clock. One Even using a cosmic divide as it expires. That was so close. But good thing U5 is still able to take this 9-12.
I was about to say that cosmic divide could have gone so wrong.
Yeah.
So Ahri. As Foxy was trying to play for the play the hero here. And you can really see the fatigue of the players take over some of their frags here. And they gotta hang on to dear life, because this is not the time to be tired.
I agree. You get to see some of the any questionable micro moves. They're still gonna try and do this, by the way. Nia, catwalk, part two. Here comes the scan, the flash, on cue, and
spike
Nia this
down,
time
mid.
Gets out. No trade at all. Now they're trying to push mid. It's a scuffle. As Twilight is ready, as well as the curtains go down, and in a flash,
Defenders
Fancy take the series 2-1, takes the fight at mid.